fight, this will be a real good move. But if you're already sweating a little bit and you're slippery, you can slip out. And that is what he's going to do. At the moment, I'm making here, I'm making fight, he's going to slip out and he's going to bail on me and I'm going to be in big trouble. Okay, so then if that happens, one, two, slip out. I better do this and hold him tight. I do not want to get hit. And then set up a different armbar. Same position and same technique. Pretty much the same technique. Only, again, if you're sweaty, they can get out. But there are many more ways to submit somebody. But first, let's do things first. We're going to go for this arm again. We're going to switch to this side. We keep it real tight on us. And now I'm going to go with my left hand. I'm going to go in, underneath, and I'm going to grab. Now let's turn a little bit to this side and show you from the side. I got him here, keep it tight, go under. Once I'm under here, slip and grab. Now with a figure four, a reverse figure four actually, again, you have to make sure that the hand has contact with his body. If it's here, I'm not going to be able to hold it. If he stretches and turns his hand down, it's going to be very difficult for me to hold. I cannot hold it. But if I bend it right away and it's on the back, on his back, his hand, the back of his hand is touching his back, there's nothing he can do. The only thing I have to do is push his hand upwards and that will be the submission. The defense for this is exactly the same thing that we did before. At the moment I go for this, you better pull it out right away. If he doesn't feel there's a danger, so like he's here and he's sitting here, and I don't use any power. I'm just leaning here, do I send me extra button? Now he's done. And right here, now he's done. So sometimes it's not good to use force, because if I use force when you're like, he's going to pull it out. But if I just lay there, and maybe I do this here, something, I'm pushing here, I distract him. I just distract him. Suddenly I slide over and go here. Once I got this, push it against his back and slide it up. Okay, so sometimes force is not the way to go to a submission because you will say, well, you give him a little alarm. You say, hey, there's a lot of power coming. He thinks, haha, I'm gone. It's the same when I do this. I grab his arm, he will pull it out. That's what he's got to do. First, this arm bar is used so many times in jiu-jitsu, but it really came to the attention when Fyodor Emelianenko did it to Mark Holland. It was in the Final Conflict, not Final Conflict, it was like the road to Final Conflict, and it made Fyodor going into the finals, the last finals, the final four. Anyway, when I was watching the fight, I was doing the color commentary on the fight, and I thought, how can Fyodor move so fast? I mean, the guy is 248, 250 pounds. Later on, I saw from a different camera angle, he used Mark Coleman's leg to turn him. Now, Mark Coleman is known for ground and pound, so they lean on their opponent and they started hitting them. Now, the arm was laying here. That was exactly what Fyodor wanted. He grabbed the leg, he slipped himself, and he had it in the armbar. Now, this armbar was fast, but you guys couldn't see what I was doing because there was a different angle. This angle was just to show you guys what a good armbar is. Now I'm going to reverse the situation so you can see what the reason was that he turned so fast. Okay, he was sitting, he was pushing forward, he grabbed his leg here, he didn't alarm him, he didn't need to because the arm was already here. The only thing he needed to do was this, and he had the armbar. He used his leg and managed to secure the armbar. The defense, obviously, is to watch out. If you fight a good submission fighter, make sure your knees are gone, not here. Don't let him grab it. Okay? Just keep tight and nice, close to your opponent, and nothing can happen. Another one. He is going to grab my neck. Now, from here, it's pretty easy to go for an armbar. Watch. Grab over, and I get the arm. Now, once I get the arm, he can even try to pull out, but I can also use this arm now. And this is a good armbar. Watch. I got this piece here in between to pull this arm through. So he will probably tap on that like this if I do it hard enough. But what I can do also is I can roll over one, two, three in this position. And I can sit, take my time, and do this. Now, this is called a numa polata, or a shoulder lock, you might call it too. You can do it with your hips and go forward, but I always prefer just to use the hand to squeeze the head forward. Now, if I don't hold his body, which is a very important thing, he can simply roll out and I'm going to lose the whole technique. All right? So it's very important, major importance, that you hold his back and just push with your hand forward. And otherwise, if you don't want to do it, you want to be really cool. But you don't need all that stuff. You know, it's just sit in a good balance and just push. It will be enough. The next one. Somebody is trying to do a can opener with you. A neck crank or, as they say, a can opener. Now, this is a really stupid move to make, actually, because in order, I saw people tapping on this move. I try, look, if you try to make,
if this is the only thing I have to do, and the pressure is off, and surprise, surprise,
I can armbar him right away. So that is an extra little thing that comes with it. Now, imagine that the armbar, you pulled it out a little bit. It doesn't matter because we're going to have this armbar here. We saw this one before. You remember the armbar that I said with hands on bracing and the other one that I did when I was sitting straight up? Well, this is actually the same one. Look, his arm bends like this. So the object is to just bend his arm here. I have a lot of space here. If I would do this, nothing's going to happen. No, I have to create space. So you see that I'm also twisting his arm. If his arm is like this, bent like this, except in my neck, see, what I do is I twist his arm, and now with the sharp bone of my wrist, I'm pulling it down. From here, there are more things that we can do. First of all, we can do an umapada. Okay? You will never expect that. So if for some reason he tries to turn off, I will right away go over, catch his leg, and just sit here and push this forward. I like to sit like this. Some people like to sit like this. This is good too because you got a good balance and you can push with your hand. Major importance in this move is that you lock his body, because if I don't lock his body, he's going to roll out and you're going to lose the position. So that's very important. Hold his body and just push with your hand. Some people sit up like this and they try to use their hips. Simply do this and simply push. They'll do the same thing. Okay? Now let's go back to that armbar that we just had. We were sitting in this armbar. And you think, oh my God, you're going to slip out. Well, then you catch his head and you go for a triangle. But, hey, listen, we're doing triangle jokes? No, we're busy with armbars. So why not give him an armbar like this? This armbar, if he turns a little bit, maybe it might not work. So why not wrap your head, put it over, and make it into a real armbar. Now, the way he set it up was with a neck crank, with the can opener, as they say. And I set it up with an armbar. I let him neck crank me on purpose. I skip my hips out of it, and then I go for an armbar. Now, if I fight against a good submission guy, I know that this guy is going to do the same thing. So I am going to give him a neck crank. But then, when he goes for the armbar, I'm going to pull the arm out, and I go for a side mount. So I'm actually going to use the neck crank, and then I let him go for an armbar, and then armbar attack, I'm going to counter attack and go to the side mount. It's going to look like this. He's neck cranking me. I go for the armbar. He pulls it out, and he's right away in the side mount, and I lost my position. You see, it's a good way to get somebody out of the guard. Get out of somebody's guard. The next armbars I'm going to give you are from a position that you have somebody in a triangle choke. Okay, now to get somebody in a triangle choke, that is also in the chokes and neck cranks chapter. I give you one way now, only one, and all the other ways I give you a little bit later. Okay, so we keep the element of surprise, so to say, and otherwise I give everything away right now and I don't want to do it. This is one of my favorite moves, though. And it really works pretty much on anybody because you distract them again and then you do something. Now, with a triangle choke, it's very important for the opponent to keep two arms outside or two arms inside because otherwise he's going to get triangled. Okay? Now, so that means you have to pass one arm and you have to leave the other arm out. Now, I say now pass one arm and leave the other arm out, but of course it's up to you what you do, left or right. This is one of my favorite moves. I grab his wrist and I grab his throat. And even if he makes a fist, I'm pushing the fist in his throat. You see where he's distracted right now. He thinks I'm choking him. I don't choke him. I just clear the path to go from the airport triangle. And I got them, by the way. The trick for a triangle scalp is to do this. This is what everybody does wrong. One, two, three. And then they're going to try to pull that foot in. It's not going to work. You have to rotate your lower body at 90 degree angle. This shin bone has to be in the same position as the shoulders. Look how easy it is right now. Now suddenly I got it. It doesn't cost me any power. I just switch my hip and I'm right there. So don't use any power and pull your foot and your feet and everything. You don't need it. Just move. Okay, one more time. Grab it, puts it against his throat. You see, he's going to probably try to get away with that throat, but it's too late. You see the 90 degree angle? That's the only thing I have to do. If I want, I can finish right now. That's it. But we are at the chapter's arm marks, like I said before. Hey, he's got his arm right here. What can we do? We can do this. That's an arm bar. What we can do? Oh, what if he's got his arm here next to me? Well, I can do this arm bar. Okay, now he's got his arm here. What we can do is simply stretch to make the arm bar, or what I did before. Grab your knee, put the foot over, and make that straight arm bar. But there's more that we can do. We can bridge up, clear the path, put his arm to the side. Right now, I said we can pull, I said we can do this, or I said we can grab the wrist, go over, and make the figure four. Now, if one of those arm bars don't work, get a gun, shoot him in the head, but make sure that your feet are away when you shoot him because you might shoot yourself. I want you guys to rewind the last part when I did all the arm bars with him when he was in my triangle choke because we choked him out. Watch it slowly because we were just cracking up here by watching it. And I want you guys to see it too because he was like laying on his floor. It was beautiful. We were probably on the internet or something. Okay, now the way to get out of the triangle choke, there are a few ways. The best way is, like I said, always two arms out, two arms in. But if they set it up the way I set it up, like a sneaky way, then it's very difficult to escape. There are a few ways, but that is going to be in the next DVD, chokes, neck cranks. I'm going to show you how to escape that. For now, I just want to say, do not get caught in a triangle choke, okay? Because this all can happen to you. Let's go to the next move. The Uma Pulada. This time, right away, without a setup or something, we're going to get him in Uma mode. He's sitting here, the arms are on the floor. Go. Correct, right foot to the side, go over him, hold it tight, and keep it tight. Important to see his arm is already stretching here while I officially have to keep it bent. So once this happens, you got to crawl up and bend it, and now it works. So if you lose that position, if it's not tight enough, simply slide under and push it up. And again, like I said the first time, if you do not hold his body, he will roll out and you're going to lose his kick. And another arm bar. This time, the opponent is pushing on your chest. He's pushing you down. Why? I don't know why. Because this is exposing your arms. This is a thing that you really don't want to do. I will show you a clip, actually, when I do this to somebody, and he's arm-barring me. It's my second bantamweight fight, all right? Now, imagine he's pushing. I'm just going to give you the arm-bar because I saw somebody in Pride getting tapped with this arm-bar. Grab the wrist, make sure it's tight, and now from the low guard, you go high, and you hook your feet, make it as tight as you can, and then you simply pull the arms out. Now, the escape for him would be to pull an arm out. Once it's over here, maybe he's doing that. But then, like we do, we can go right away and do this arm bar. And even though if this arm is going to be here, we have this arm bar. But those arm bars we already went through, so we know what we can do. Alright? So never, ever stretch your arms when you're in the guard of an opponent. The next one is called the reverse figure four, or people in America, chicken wing is what they call it. You can force your way in, but that's another way. If I grab somebody's hand, first of all, what did I say? You're going to pull it out. So you got to go fast. It's kind of a snake move. It's not this. Imagine he's not pulling it out. You let me get it. I go like.
second maneuver. You know, okay? It's got to go a little bit faster. Go a little bit more sideways. All right? Good. Now, I visualize myself doing this whole exercise. This is what I think. I open my legs, grab, snake myself around, go, and get it. Push the hand on the back, and then push it up. Otherwise, it won't work. Okay? If it's stretched, I told you before, he's going to get out, and you're going to lose the position. This way, it's going to go. You're sitting, sitting here in front of him. This is it. That's the speed you got to do. You do less speed, he's going to get out. Touch his back, otherwise it's not going to work. Okay? Now, the escape. Why should you feel somebody doing this? Pull it out. Oh, pull it out. Or he wanted to do a really nice other one. He's going to grab the inside of his leg, and I was going to put his knee on the floor, west. And I can do whatever I want, but it's going to be very difficult. But the same thing counts for what I did before. If you pull, he's pushing right now. No, actually, he's pulling too. I'm pulling, he's pulling. So why don't I go with his pull? I'm pulling, pulling, and suddenly I'm going to push, and I'm going to break and bring it here. Okay, so that would be a way to escape that situation again. But officially, this would be a real good thing to do. Actually, in Pampers, I would do things like this. Let's reverse the situation. Watch. Somebody would get in here for one, I grab here, and I put it down, and it would start pulling its power. And I would do this. I would just make sounds. I don't have to make any sounds because there is no power. But because I make sounds, he thinks I'm really fighting it. But I'm not fighting it. I just do in order for him to waste all his energy. And once his energy is wasted after 1 minute, trust me, 1 minute is really fast, he's got to go. And trust, this is a real nice thing you can do. So they go over, go, and right leg into a side jump. But that's a nice little option, and that option will work if somebody's really tired, and if they just threw all the way the power that they have with trying to escape the Kimura. Then again, he's in my guard. Everybody now knows that you probably go for this move. So I thought, why is everybody going for that move? Why can do it different too? He's sitting up, touching me. I think, why did I never see anybody go inside here like this? And it's the same thing. It is the same thing. Make a fist, make it really strong, and just push it arm up. Make sure your guard is closed, because if you don't close your guard, you will roll out. Okay, this is very important. Also with the other keyboard that we just did, if you do not close your guard, he will roll out. So always close your guard, or at least catch a leg, or catch one leg. But the most safe thing is, crush your legs, nothing can happen. Okay, one more time. Slow. Grabbing, going inside. Everybody expects this. Nobody expects this and this. And that's it. And if you make a strong fist, trust me, this is a really strong hold. Just keep his hand on his back and push up. And he will tap. The escape is exactly the same as with the normal chicken wing, the reverse figure four. I grab him, and that's it. Once the thing is secured, or if I do this, he can still pull out now. He can still pull out now. But like I said before, I'm not going to do it that slow speed. You know, I'm going to sit and wait, then we'll make some mistakes, and that's it. That's the speed you have to do it. Otherwise, it's not going to work. Okay, don't give him a chance to escape. Pow! Visualize yourself doing it. Bang! Next move is the move. That's it. Okay? Worse. Okay, now, let's go back a little bit. Remember, I went from this to the floor, and he was defending like this. He was grabbing it and pulling it like that. And like I said, if he starts making sounds while I'm pulling, I think that he's in trouble. But don't get him in trouble. The thing that you have to do is, like I said, you got to pull, and suddenly you got to push, grab it loose, and then go for this. Now, of course, there are people who can hold it and keep holding it. Now, if that happens, don't worry. Happened to me too. Simply hold, replace.
place your hand to the chest and put this one low. Put your foot on the ground, and with this foot, you're going to explode up. And you're going to reverse it. And now you're in the mount position. And that is the next chapter. Arm bars to the mount.
Sorry.
Arm bars from the mount position. We are very limited with making arm bars from the mount position. Officially, I would say go to the side mount. Because, as you can see, we had a lot of arm bars from the side mount. We don't have a lot of arm bars from the mount position because the mount is easy to escape. I will show you that later in the other DVD, escapes and reversals. Okay, so everybody always says the mount position is a great position. I don't think so. I mean, if I want to punch you, the only thing he has to do is bug up, and I have to look for balance, so I can't punch him. The same thing here. If I would go for an armbar and he bucks right out, I lose my balance again. Of course, I can try to go for a different armbar, but like I always say, if you want to go for one armbar, let's stay with that armbar. Okay, here we go. The first one. I'm going to grab his tricep. I'm going to sit high on his chest. I sit high on his chest because if he bucks up now, see, now there's not a lot of action in me. And now I can pretty much keep my balance. So I sit really high, cross-facing to the side. Why do I cross-facing to the side? If I don't cross-facing to the side, or if I cross-facing to this side, I'm going to step over, he's going to pull out. There's nothing I can do. So I have to make sure that his body cannot turn that way. So I cross-face him. Now I take my time, go to the side, and see how tight I'm sitting on his shoulder. I don't go up, I stay down, very tight. I'm going to keep my hand on his jaw, going to put my foot over his jaw, and then I'm going to let my arm go and go for a straight armbar. Push it down, put the foot over, and go for the armbar. And again, pull it a little bit to the side and not to this side. Alright? Now, the escape. Like in every other armbar we had from the side mount, simply push the leg off that I want to throw over his head. So, if I'm sitting here and I cross face him, he doesn't need to be worried at all. He only has to make sure that I cannot throw my leg over his head. Stepping, going here, he's pushing it off, and right now he's in my guard. Of course, we have a lot of action and armbar that we can do from the guard. We just saw it, but we don't want to have it. We want to go for the straight armbar from the mount. All right, now, after seeing that first armbar, I thought with myself, hey, listen, if this is so easy to escape simply by him bucking up, why won't I come up with something that he cannot buck up? Now, first of all, I'm going to start low. I'm going to start here. And even if his elbows are here, I'm going to put my arms under here, and I'm going to crawl it up all the way to the front. And now I'm really high, and he can buck whatever he wants. There's no way that he can get out. Now, watch what I'm going to do. It's going to be very difficult, but very effective. I'm going to grab the back of his head. You want to grab the top. You don't want to grab the neck. If you grab the neck and he pushes his head backwards, see, I can pull whatever I want. There is no power. There's no leverage. We got to grab the top of the head. You can do it with two hands. First, one hand, because this hand you need to pose, and you're going to put this foot out. Now you can go here, and you do this. Now you start pulling. If you pull, maybe he already is going to tap. But if he doesn't pull, you're going to grab one arm in here, and now you're setting it up for this arm right here. Watch the slow-mo first what I'm going to do. I'm going to cross-face him still. Cross face him, throw my leg over, and make an armbar. First slow-mo. One, two, three. One more time, and I'm now going to do it in a little bit more speed. Okay, so you can see what it looks like when you do it in normal speed. Because obviously, I'm not going to do it as slow as I just did before. Now, his arms are here. If his elbows are there, just dig in here. Come underneath and bring it up. Now, use his head here. To push yourself up. Okay? He's still going to give it to you. It's not like that simple what I'm doing now. So you really have to work for it. But once you're here, it's going to be very difficult for him to stop me. I grab his head on high on the top, at the top of his head. I put one foot out, and then I put the other foot out. I'm going to pull as hard as I can. If I'm sitting too low, if I sit here, now he simply has to sit up, and I lose my position. So you don't want to sit too low. You want to sit high on his chest. Okay. You sit high on the chest. One, two. We're going to put this arm in between because we're going to go for this arm bar. I'm going to cross faces and I'm going to go for a straight arm bar. It's a fast move and it really works. So try it out. BSK is exactly like in every other arm bar. You heard me saying it to you, telling it to you like 50 times right now, maybe 25. Let's not exaggerate. But simply make sure that I cannot throw my leg over his head. So you have to push it off. Make sure I cannot bring it over. But in this situation, it's going to be very difficult because this is a stress situation. I'm pulling his head as high as I can. I'm neck cracking him right there. What he's trying to do is, or he's going to try to push me away, which would make it even better, because check this out. If I'm sitting here in this position and he pushes me under the jaw, I mean, now the sky's the limit. You see, I can go left, right, armor, or anything else, and go to the center. I get any armor that I want. And some people do that as an escape. Would be very stupid to do, but you have people who do it. Also, another thing that comes with it is, if I'm pulling his head, his automatic reflex is to bring his head back, because you're neck cranking him. And it hurts, so he has to put it back. So at the moment you let his head go, it will slam back into the mat. He doesn't have the time to block the leg that you're going to throw over. Okay? So it's a whole combination. You're pulling, 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 pulling. The only thing that he can do is or tap or pushing me off. And if he doesn't tap, he's very flexible. You go for that armbar. But don't forget the cross face. One more time. I'm going to show you. I'm sitting here. We saw how we got in this position, so I'm not going to show you that anymore. I'm sitting here. I grab this arm. And from here, watch slow-mo is going to be this and this. That's going to be the slow-mo. Don't forget the cross-face. Another defense that I want to go over with, and let's do this with every armbar. It's very simple. If I want to go underneath his neck and he just presses his head on the floor, it's very difficult for me to get under. I really have to dig, and then go forward. But most of the time, just for him to press his neck on the ground, it will work. I cannot get my head underneath. Now, I'm very blessed because I got the trapezius here. And if I put this up and I press myself on the floor, it's going to be very hard for him to get underneath my neck. Okay, so that's a good defense. But let's show you a few more. Well, anyway, if somebody lays with a hammerlock or something like that, just press it as hard as you can on the floor. If you press it down. They can't get on it. It's very difficult to get on it. When I lay on the floor and people try to get underneath my arm, check it out. Oh, let's lay in the same position. Anyone's still on my arm, I'm putting all my body weight on there. See? All my body weight is turning. You see, I'm pushing with my foot to the side. He can't get under. And once he can't get under, there is no hammerlock. It's the other way around, too. If here, if he wants to get under, I'm just pressing my whole shoulder. You see, I'm laying, I'm pushing with this leg, my body weight all the way to the side, and he simply can't get under. It's a very easy thing to do. And with his neck, the same thing. See, if I do this, he can't get under my neck because my traps are there and my neck is there. So if you can do that, they cannot even grab your neck. Big mistake that you see people make is to try to go for a figure four from the mouth. I don't know why they do it. It doesn't work. Because watch this. If I go around his neck, and later on in the escapes and reversals, I will go over this again, I'm taking away this. Look, if I take away this, and he takes away that foot by simply, what's going to do with his foot? He's going to lock off my foot, so I cannot push my foot out. He's going to lock it up. Now, if I go for a figure four, it's pretty much the same thing. Look, because I have nothing here to bridge, and I have nothing here to put my foot out, because he's going to lug it up with his foot all the way as tight. gets in retirement. And how he's going to pull it out. And then maybe we can, of course, vote for different armbars. But again, you lost your position. You lost the mount position, which is a very intimidating position. And for mounts, you can study mounts, you can move all the way around. It's just a position you do not want to give up. So never try to go for a hammerlock, unless you're a Bas Rutten, because now I'm going to give you one that really works. And like I said, of course, I have an answer for this. You can make a figure four, but you have to work a little bit. What you have to do is go from a mount position to a half guard. Of course, you can also go from a mount position all the way around and to a side mount and then finish it. So that's also an option you can do, and it's probably easier. But this is the thing. If I go for a head guard first, he really doesn't know what's going to happen. And if I see his arm laying there all the time, that's him asking me, please, boss, armbar me. I mean, of course, he doesn't mean it like that, but I mean, he's giving it to me. So this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to go from guard, from mount, to a half guard. I'm going to unhook this leg. Let's turn to the side and see how I got it hooked. Now, this is very important. I'm going to do it with this foot. Why? Watch. If I do it with this foot, I go for the hammerlock, he's going to turn me again. It's not going to work. Okay? So I have to do it with my right leg. Because now, if I get the arm and he tries to turn me, there's no way. I got a block there. He cannot pull me over. Now, from this position, back to here, I'm going to press as hard as I can with my hip on his hip. I'm really doing this, like a bird nest. Okay? Grab it, bird nest, and bring it down. And there's nothing he can do. He cannot hold out because you locked up his hip, you have his arm, and I go up. That's it. There's nothing he can do. Another one. First, let me show you the hammerlock. If I do like this, he simply turns on his side. See? There's nothing I can do. And he can turn me, like I said before. So there is no hammerlock. What you can do is get the arm lock, the hammerlock, and right away go to a side mount position from him, side mount, and then finish him off like that. Go to the side mount. We had this arm lock already in side mount, and I explained to you what to do with your hand. Bring it in the same line as the shoulders. And if you didn't see it, take back the chapters and watch it again, because there I really tell you to the detail how it works. One more thing that I want to tell you. If this guy is a good submission guy, he doesn't care if I go for a hammerlock. Nobody is going to give his hammerlock to you. Nobody's going to do that. But a good submission guy on the bottom, the guy, if he's good, he knows that you cannot do anything with it unless you're going to lock this hip up like we did before, or unless you jump to the side mount. So that's why people say now, yeah, but they're never going to give this arm to you. You will be surprised because they think, hey, if I'm going to get that arm, he's going to make a turn again. You see? So that's what they think he's going to do. But you don't. You don't let him make the turn. You go right away to the side mount or right away to the half guard and you buck up like I just explained to you a few chapters back. Like I said before, it's very dumb for people to this and try to push you away. I mean, we saw it in many fights. We actually saw Picada doing it with Hitchin, like, straight away from me. I mean, that's, please give me an armbar. This is something you never want to do. And don't worry, I made the same mistake. Like I said before, my second Pangras fight, I was pushing the guy away, bang, he got me right away in an armbar. So, everybody can make a mistake. Like I said, under stress, there's a lot of things that you don't think about. Major rule, just keep your arms here, all right? Now, imagine the guy has an arm around your neck. He thinks, you know what, I have him in mount position. I don't want him to start pushing me, so he grabs me and he pulls me close to him. Now, the way to break his grip is very simple. It's a crossface that you're going to do. Now, while I'm going to do a crossface, I'm going to make an arm bar right away. This time, I want to make a crossface to that side because I'm going to use this arm. Watch. To break this grip, he can. The tiger holds me. If I do this, he is going to break his grip. I'm going to move up, and while I'm moving up, I have to push his arm against my neck. Otherwise, he will go around and strip off my head. So I really have to push, and you see my neck is going to the side. I have to try to catch this arm. It's very important. All
All right, so one more time.
You call me?
Just cross me. He has to go and hold him like this. Now go from here. Keep pushing, and cross-tracing. Cross-tracing is one of the most important things to do. Now you're going to think that you're going to go for this arm, but you're not. You're going to jump over to this side, roll over with your knee here, your right knee here, and your left knee over here, and you're going to make an arm bar that we had before. Watch. One, two, three. Now, there's space here in between. If I was laying flat on him, there's nothing to pull through. No. I need space in order to break his arm. I know it sounds really, really aggressive, but hey, you want to let him tap? You're not going to let him tap, but let him lift his arm and pull it against your chest. Nothing's going to happen now. You have to create space. This space with your hand, create space here, and now pull his arm inside, and that is the tap. Press this down as hard as you can, because his escape is going to be push the leg off of the foot and then pull it up. That is his escape. So this submission you have to make fast, then he doesn't have the time to push it up. Squeeze your legs, do it right away, make sure he taps, and then there's no escape. Now, we take this arm, and normally I would tell you to cross-face him to this side. Well, in this case, we are not going to do it. We're going to cross-face him to this side. Later on, you'll understand why. I'm going to move this foot from here to here on his head. From the side, that'll look like this. I have him cross face to this side. I got the arm here, so this is locked up, and I'll simply do this. And I put my whole body weight on his body, because if I don't, he can maybe explode to the right. I say maybe, but I don't think so, because if he does, he's going to break his own neck, because I cross-faced him to this side. That is the reason I didn't cross-face him to that side, because now maybe he can roll out that way, okay? So cross-face him to this side. Keep your hand on his jaw. There is no reason to let the hand go. Keep the hand there. Simply step over, and here, simply bridge, and make the armbar. Now, if it's going to be really tough, and he explodes to try to get out, well, you got an armbar right there. There's no escape from this one. Again, the only thing, if I forget to squeeze my knees, he can push my knee up, and then he escapes. That's the only thing. But I make sure that I squeeze my knees together. A simple wrist lock will do the trick. Now, not always. I'll show you a piece, a little clip of a fight, that I had a wrist lock on a person, and his hand was already here. And I'm pushing and pushing. And you will actually hear me saying to my corner, he's made of rubber. I thought the guy was made of rubber. It was unbelievable. He had a big pain face. He was really like, it was hurting, but he didn't tap.
膝で control. 相手の膝をして control しろ. 相手の膝、自分の左に出れ. 胴ぶつかるよ. 相手の膝をして. 相手の膝を出せ.
So, if he's very flexible, it's not going to work. But not a lot of fighters are very flexible in their wrists. Why? They develop the wrist strength with weights, with everything, because you want to have a strong grip. With a strong grip comes a lot of muscles here, which makes it not more flexible. Or you really have to flex every time after you did the power exercises. Trust me, a lot of people don't do that. Now, the wrist. He's laying here defending himself. I'm grabbing the wrist on the top. I go underneath and I use this hand to bend it. See what I did? One more time. I grab, even if his hand is here, I go overhand grip and I grab my with my fingers here. That's where I'm going to grab. Inside, because now I can bend it. Even though he keeps it straight, try to keep it straight, and I go underneath here and I push this down, for sure, it's going to be bad. Now, I bring his arm to my chest because I want to lay on his chest. Once this hand is bent, I can use one hand. Don't worry about it. The only thing I have to make sure of is that he doesn't slip out on that side. That's why I told you, you have to block it up. Now, from this position, I'm going to use this other hand too because one hand has power. Two hands, double power. And that's what we want, double the power.
I show you first how it works. From here, I'm going to pull it down, and it's going to tap. But just to secure everything, his elbow is here in my hip, so he can't pull it out. And if I lay on him, look, if I won't lay on him, he's just going to do this, and he's going to be out. So I have to put my chest on his arm, and now I get the wrist lock. And you see, he's trying to bridge me up, but watch. My feet are under here, and I get the other hooks. He can try anything he wants, but I have the wrist lock. There's no way that he can stop this. Once it's on, it's on. The defense, don't get caught. Again, told you many times, when I grab it, get out. Don't let anybody grab something. I won't make exaggerated moves. If like somebody grabs me by the head, I would just simply do this. I would never do like this. This is a dangerous thing to do because maybe it's a setup for him, like to go for a triangle. Imagine I'm in the dark, and then he holds my wrist, and I pull it out, and suddenly he passes his arm, and he goes for a triangle. So try to make your escapes as small as possible. Just do this, okay? Just stretch them out, but don't start making big movements. It's always wrong. Don't let him grab your wrist. I like to call this one a golden oldie. This is one of the first arm bars I knew. It's really fast. You have to be a little flexible. Trust me, I'm not that flexible. You see me making the rooting jump, it's all optical illusion. Because my legs are here, but because the camera is in front of me, you see, it looks like it's stretched. You don't see the difference pretty much between this and this. So I'm not that flexible, but flexible enough to do this move. Okay, first of all, we sit high up and we push his head to the side. From here, I'm going to throw my right foot over to this side, and that's it. Watch. My toes are here, securing his head, and now the only thing I have to do is pull. Now, if he tries to escape, the only thing he can do is buck up again and then try to throw it. Right. He bucks up, I go here, and then I go for a full armbar. So don't worry. The escape for him would be make sure that I cannot throw my foot over his face. But as you can see, if I'm sitting here and I do this, he's not going to stop that. There's no way that he's going to stop this leg. So if he can't stop it, hey, that's the escape. But I'm telling you right now, he's not going to expect this move. Another arm bar from the mount position. It's a tricky one, and you really have to practice this one. You have to keep pulling his arm all the time, and we're going to make a 360-degree angle all around him. You will never expect this. Start up like this. Grab around his shoulder. Now I'm going to cross-face him to the side. I'm going to step up from here. I'm going to turn, and I keep everything in the same spot pretty much. Turn, and I'm going to keep pulling this arm all the way to here, and then I'm going to go into an armbar. As you can see, this has to be really tight, because if I'm going to be here, he's going to escape it already, okay? So you need to be really tight on the shoulder, and that's why you really have to pull up his shoulder, and while you make the turn, you have to keep pulling his arm. Okay, so this is how it looks when you do it fast. Don't forget the cross face, very important. Okay, because if I don't cross face him, he can pull his arm out. If I do this, now he can turn himself to this side. You don't want to have that. You want to do everything in the blink of an eye. All right? So we lay here, we cross face, we step, and I'm going to go all around and make the arm out. There's no way that he can sit up because my knee is here and I got a good control over his arm. Best thing again, this part of his elbow, put it here on your groin, or even if you have the chance, a little bit to this side, and then we book that side. So, the two escapes were, if he tries to put his leg over your head, just stop it like this. That's the best way, always the best way. Don't let him put his leg over your head, alright? But if he managed to get his leg over your head, and even if he's got his feet crossed, now I can't push it up anymore. Now I better make sure that if he's going to break my grip, the elbow is going to be here, see? So right away from this position, I already do this. A little bit, not too much. You never know if he knows this escape. Just a little bit here. And now when he starts pulling, I let him pull. And at the moment, he's going to stretch it. Pull, 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 pull. I'm going to explode up over my head and over my left shoulder. 1, 2, 3, 4. I go to the side mount position. A new chapter, arm bars from different positions. I
call it this way because there are many other different positions than side mount and end mount and a half mount or whatever, okay? But right now, we're going to get somebody's back. I'm going to be on all fours. Somebody's going to have my back. We're going to go through different positions that you can be in and still can make arm bars. This is a common position. I'm on all fours, and somebody's sitting around here and has an arm here. This is not a very smart thing for him to do. Because right here, if I grab his wrist, I got to already start making this. Yeah. I got to block his foot. Because what happens? What did I say before? As soon as I grab something, he's probably going to try to pull it out. Now, here I'm pretty strong. Because and he's pretty tight on me, so it's going to be pretty difficult to see to pull out. It's going to be pretty difficult. But still, I want to react to him. So once I'm here, I'm going to grab the wrist. I'm going to bring this leg over right away to this side. I don't know if you can see it from here. I catch this leg. If I don't catch this leg and I make an arm bar, he's going to roll out. Okay? Later, we will talk about that because, of course, there are things that you can do that. But first thing is, we sit here, we're all fours, he goes around, and I'm going to concentrate on this arm now. I'm just holding it. Don't hold it too tight, that something's going to happen. I'm going to make a big turn all the way here, catch this leg, bend it. And that is already an arm bar right here. Make sure again, like I told you before, this arm needs to be bent and on his chest. Up, back, on his back. Alright? Next one, same position. This time he's not gonna go underneath your body. So you can't go for a figure four, but you can go for a different arm bar. He's gonna try to sort of choke in. Okay, here we go. Sitting in the same position, turn position. And he's defending and he's coming in. Right away when he comes in, you're grabbing his wrist. Now go around and grab your own head and twist. And now it's very important to lock this leg and preferably lock this foot up like this so he can't pull it out. If I do this, he can pull it out. Okay, put it back and he can roll out. Now come back. If I have one foot here, here, and the other one is up, yeah, I was tied it up like this. It's very difficult for him now to kick it out, you see? Plus, of course, I'm not going to wait till he's going to kick this thing out. I'm going to submit right away by pushing this out. So simply go back of your head and push this one up. Make sure that you lock the leg right away. One more time, more realistic speed. The catch is the most important thing. Catch his foot so he can't kick it out. Even though when he kicks it out, just jerk the shoulder so he's going to tap. And if he continues to fight, he has to fight with a hurt shoulder. So it's always good. Okay, but it's better when you trap the leg because then there's no escape. You're sitting, he goes around, and he goes for this jerk. Now you concentrate because you know his leg is here. Right away, step over and lock this under and make it. You see what happens? This is a straight arm bar, but you also bend it and go for this one. Two arm bars, straight, and one bent. And he got the leg. Very important. This position, again, he's sitting on all fours. Now, his hands are here, and we need to create space. I want to put my foot in here, but if the space is there, it's going to be difficult to force my foot in. Okay? So what I do is I neck crank him to the other side. Look what I do. I hold his shoulder. It's that easy. He's neck cranking. There's nothing he can do. He can do one thing, and that is looking upwards, but that will give him right away an opportunity for me, if you go up with your face, joke. So he will never do that. Okay, he always will stay in this position. So that's the first thing you do. Slide in, hold his tricep. Now you dig in, take it away, and now you lock both feet, as you can see here, my two feet are together, and you're going to bridge, and with your butt here, with your crotch, holding his arm down while you're cross-facing him. This is a perfect arm bar. Well, another different position. He's got your back, and obviously he is going to try to choke you. Now, there's a lot of things that you can do. I came up with a really crazy arm bar, and it works. And if it doesn't work, there's another one. And if that doesn't work, there's another one, and we can go on and on and on. And eventually, if nothing works, we're going going to use that arm to improve our position. But let's just start by the beginning, all right? First of all, you have to make sure that you defend the jump. Now, if I do this, chances are that he's going to dive in on this side, okay? No, go on the other side. Well, here, because we're going to let him go. Most important thing right now is to grab the inside of his hand. Because if you grab the hand, you control the whole arm. If I grab his wrist, you can simply twist it and turn it. There's nothing that I can do. So this is major important. If you don't do it, it's not going to work. Now, watch what I'm going to do. I'm going to pull it a little bit. And I'm going to put my hand behind my head. I'm going to push my head back. And now I'm going to press his arm to the side. And that's already an armbar. A lot of people are very strong. Before I go further, I have to tell you, if you do the armbar here, obviously it's not going to work. You have to be under the part that bends. Here has to be, okay? If you're here, it's not going to work. It's going to be here or even higher. And what I do is grab, and I even arch backwards, and then I make the armbar. Now, imagine it doesn't work. You can go for something stronger. Push yourself a little bit more upwards. Keep this hand, because you got a little bit of control of it. Go over it, put this hand on your shoulder, on your chest, make it a fist. I always feel that if you make a fist, that you have more power. You know, together we stand strong. Well, okay, it's probably coming from that. Make a fist, it's strong, and now just bend it this way. Okay, if that doesn't work, again, roll on your side, and now you have to bend this arm, and there is a wrist lock again. If I don't bend his arm, watch. If I have his arm like this, he simply can pull out, and I'm going to lose the position. So that's why I told you, you have to climb up high, put it on the floor, and bend his arm. Now he can't pull it out, because his arm is bent this way, and I'm locking it up. It's very difficult for him to pull it out. Now, if everything is going to fail, you do this, you keep it tight, you bring the arm to the other side. Now you can even try an arm on like this. And if that doesn't work, you're going to improve your position by simply pushing with your head to the side and explode. And now you're going to be in his guard, which is always better than when he has your back. All right, this move is taught to me by Marcus Vinicius. He's the owner of the Beverly Hills Jiu-Jitsu Club. He said, "Bas, lay down. I'm going to show you a really cool move, and I think it is a really cool armor. Watch this. We're sitting in this position, we have both controls, so he cannot move to the left or to the right. I got a good control. Now I'm going to change my hand position. I'm going to go with two hands on one arm. I'm going to bring it up, create a hole, and I'm going to put my foot in between. Now watch what I'm going to do. I'm going to put my foot on the floor, and I'm going to press it on the floor as hard as I can. Otherwise, he's going to pass my foot with his arm. So that's very important. But I'm also going to control this arm. So this is what I'm going to do. Push to the side and control this arm. Now, I'm going to jump over. One, two, and here. And watch from this position. We have seen this many times before. There is a space here. I grab it and I pull it to me. And that is the armbar. All right, here we go. One more time. Okay, let's speed it up a little bit. Grab, push it over, and then down. Okay, while we're here, in the same position as we were in the last time, might as well go for an armbar. Now, we have to keep him a little bit upwards, because if you put him on his side, he cannot slide his leg up. It's not going to work. So you got to keep him in this position, and you have to cross-face him. Cross-face him to this side. Bring your leg over, and now go for an armbar. If you can, wash your feet. And be straight, as always. Do not let my leg go over his head. All right? It's going to be difficult, because I'm really going to try to force it. So if I'm in this position, and I'm holding it, I'm going to go here. This is what's going to happen. See? If he would be here, I can still make the armbar. So he really has to make sure that he keeps pushing there, and don't let my leg come up, and now he will be out. Never bring the leg over the head. That's probably the 25th time that I told you now. Side mount position. This time, he's playing a smart game. He has one leg here, and he's got one arm here. Now, one arm
against him, but that's later for the chokes and neck rings, okay? Right now, it also kind of works against him, but even, you know what, can't put his arm here, and we're going to force the arm to the other side. So let's say that he starts from this position. I'm going to push this away and put this over, and I'm going to lock it. Now from here, I'm going to try to turn like this. You see what I did? One, and I, with my bone, I slide this to the side, grab it, and of course, I got here a figure four. Push up, and that's it. He can't pull out right now. Trust me. The escape is don't let this leg go around the arm, because I'm going to really force and try to get up this. Don't let me do it. Now he's got my foot. This is going to be dangerous. Watch. Now I still got it. Push to the side, grab, and I got it. So watch out. He really has to make sure that my leg cannot pass his head. He's in your side mount. He has the side mount on me. And I want to figure four this arm. Reverse figure four, the chicken wing. I told you in the beginning I wouldn't go there, but it's a reverse figure four. Okay, now, first of all, most important, his arm is going to be here. So he's not going to give it to me. There are two things that I can do. I can try to really force and push it. Push foot against the leg. I can maybe try to force it in. Or I can do something really simple. I can create space myself by bringing my head to the side and do this. Once it's here, trust me, if I bring my head up and I do this, the arm is going to be there. I'm going to catch it like this, go under, grab, and make a fist, and that will be the figure four. What did I forget to do right now? I forgot to lock this leg. If I don't lock this leg, he's going to roll out. But no worries, because like Sakharova did, you're just going to roll with him, and you're going to go for exactly the same armbar, only now he's going to be on his back. So roll with him, one, two, to foot over, and then finish the armbar. As long as you know that if you lose that control, just roll with him. And then you have exactly the same armbar over the outside, the other way around. One more time, I'm going to do it for realistic speed, all right? Because I want you guys to show that I did not forget to lock this leg up, because I said that at the end of the time. Let's just make a point, all right? So we're sitting here, it's pushing there. Go up, here, grab it. Push it up and lock the leg. There's nothing that he can do right now. Simply finish it up by pushing and keep the hand on his back, pushing it up. Do not forget to lock the leg, because you saw one chapter before what can happen. We talked about this hold before. It's dangerous to do it because I can turn you. Okay, now I also showed you what to do if somebody tries to turn you. If you don't know, if you don't remember anymore, again, go back into chapters and I will explain to you there what to do. But now let's just imagine that this guy doesn't think about positioning first. And I can really tell you that 90% of the people, or 95% of the people, once they have a hold on you, and even when you turn them, they forget their positioning. They keep holding you. Positioning first. I told you many times, let go of the hold. First positioning, and then you go again for an attack. Okay? So, let's make sure he's dumb. He's not a dumb guy. He's on the right. He's very smart. But now, I mean, you got to play dumb now. Okay, he's going to play dumb. Right, and this combination always works. If somebody holds me like this, and he doesn't know how to defend it, watch how fast this goes. I'm going to roll against him, grab my hands together, one, two, roll, I'm already sort of catching him, step over, and I'm making a straight armbar. It's a real fast move, and you will catch him by surprise. Why are you going to catch him by surprise? Very simple. You roll him, and in his mind, he's thinking, oh my God, he's rolling me. That's the wrong thought. You shouldn't think that, because once he thinks that, he doesn't think about a counterattack that might come. And that's the moment he's off. That's the moment you're going to counterattack with a straight armbar. Remember, cross-face him. One more time. Slow-mo now. This is fast. He's going to go over and watch. Here, already cross-face him and look how I stay on him. How long? Go back. And again, I pull this arm to this side, this to this side, and I put my knees together and arm right. discrimination you make when somebody puts a guillotine choke on you. I know this is not the chapter. This is not the DVD with chokes and neck cranks. But still, it's a nice escape, and you can go from that escape straight into a nice chicken wing or a reverse figure four. Oh, my God. Now I'm mixing it up. All right. Just make sure that if he falls backwards and he tries to put his legs around you, that he cannot do it. And it's very simple. The only thing I have to do is to steer his legs and step to the other side. If the guillotine choke is going to be here, I'm going to go with my legs to that side. One second. If the guillotine choke is going to be here, I'm going to go with my legs to that side. Okay? That is very important. Hold his legs because he wants to pull guard. This is what he wants to do. One, he's got it, pull guard, and now I'm done. Now, actually, not really done because I have a real good defense for this one. But again, that's a different DVD. But let's stick with this now. At the moment he takes the guillotine, he wants to fall back. I simply control his legs and I go to the side. Now there is nothing. He's pulling the side of my neck. He can pull whatever he wants to pull. You see, I can talk. I can eat if I want, drink a beer, or smoke a cigarette on the side. Now, if I want him to let go of his grip, because I want to armbar him, I'm going to set him up. What's going to do? I'm going to grab his hand, but he won't let go. Oh, you don't want to let go? Prostration to this side. Now watch. If I'm going to push, he has to let go. Okay, straight. He's going to go into a figure four. Just make sure, step over, and bring his arm over the floor to that side. I'm not going to do it because Amir has a bad shoulder.